What should I do?
Ah, ich weiß.
Hallo und willkommen. Ich bin Meister Lenze and you're watching Get Germanized, different and better ways of saying sorry in German. In this series we talk about, well, better and different words to say certain things in German, auf Deutsch. And in this episode, well, we'll talk about saying sorry. The first way Germans use to express, well, that they're very apologetic is, oh, Entschuldigung, Entschuldigung. 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 Entschuldigung is very casual and can be used in all different kinds of situations. For example, when you bump into someone in the street, like, oh, Entschuldigung. Or if you want to ask someone something while being out and about, you say, oh, Entschuldigung, Entschuldigung, can I talk to you for a second? Entschuldigung. This is only used when you are sorry for something you have done, basically. Entschuldigung, oh, Entschuldigung, I'm disturbing you. Not when someone else, for example, loses their job or something similar, then you wouldn't say, oh, Entschuldigung, that doesn't fit. Entschuldigung as a noun would be the apology, die Entschuldigung. And sich entschuldigen would be to ask for forgiveness or to say that you're sorry. Sich entschuldigen. There are different ways to use this. For example, you could say, ich entschuldige mich aufrichtig. Ich entschuldige mich aufrichtig. I sincerely apologize. Ich entschuldige mich aufrichtig. That sounds very formal though, so you wouldn't say that to a friend that, well, you have wronged. Ich entschuldige mich aufrichtig. That could sound a bit ironic, not like you really mean it if you use it in a casual situation. Ich entschuldige mich aufrichtig. Could be used in the office, probably. I always talk about bosses because, well, in Germany, it is important that there is politeness where it's meant to be, where it's due. I know that in countries where you only use you and don't have the different forms, it is not as important, probably, and it's more laissez-faire, it's more on the same level in the workplace, maybe in some places. But in Germany, in a normal situation, it is just the way to go, to be polite to your boss. And so that is probably where you can use ich entschuldige mich aufrichtig as well. Another one would be entschuldige, dass ich so egoistisch bin. Entschuldige, dass ich so egoistisch bin. This can be used in a personal setting, I would say. Entschuldige, dass ich so egoistisch bin. Or better even, entschuldige, dass ich so egoistisch war. Meaning, sorry for having been so selfish. I mean, you can of course also apologize for still being selfish, that is possible. But if you want to say that you have been selfish and want to apologize for that, then entschuldige, dass ich so egoistisch war, is better. Another very casual way of saying sorry is entschuldige bitte. Entschuldige bitte. Entschuldige bitte. I'm sorry. For example, if someone tells you, wow, the way you treated my grandpa was really not that great, then you could say, oh, entschuldige bitte. Entschuldige bitte. I'm sorry for doing that. Entschuldige bitte, dass ich das getan habe. Ich hatte einen schlechten Tag. Entschuldige bitte, dass ich das getan habe. Ich hatte einen schlechten Tag. Sorry for having done that. I had a bad day. That could work in that situation. Like I said, these are just examples. There are a million different ways of saying sorry in German. For example, ich würde mich gerne entschuldigen. Ich würde mich gerne entschuldigen. Ich würde mich gerne entschuldigen, meaning I would like to say sorry. Or I would like to apologize. You could also say, entschuldige, dass ich so spät dran bin. Entschuldige, dass ich so spät dran bin. I'm sorry for being so late. Or if you want to ask someone to forgive you, to accept your apology, then you can say, bitte nimm meine Entschuldigung an. Bitte nimm meine Entschuldigung an. Or if you want to be polite and talk to someone higher, in higher position than you, then you can say, bitte nehmen Sie meine Entschuldigung an. Bitte nehmen Sie meine Entschuldigung an. Then there is the archaic, or at least a little bit archaic, Verzeihung. It's basically like pardon in English. You wouldn't really use it in many situations. I can't think of any where I would use it personally. It is Verzeihung. Verzeihung. You would often hear this in movies that are set in a time around maybe, I don't know actually where they would set that movie, but in the past for sure. Something that you could use, in my opinion at least, is Ich hoffe du verzeihst mir. Ich hoffe du verzeihst mir is I hope you can forgive me, or I hope you forgive me. Ich hoffe du verzeihst mir. Or of course the polite form, ich hoffe sie verzeihen mir. Ich hoffe sie verzeihen mir. Something else that is a little bit old fashioned but can still be used is ich bitte sie um Verzeihung. Ich bitte sie um Verzeihung, or just ich bitte um Verzeihung. I ask for forgiveness, or I ask you for forgiveness. Ich bitte sie um Verzeihung is the polite way of saying I ask you for forgiveness. And ich bitte um Verzeihung is also polite, but doesn't address anyone in specific. Maybe the butler would say that to a group of lords. So, ich bitte um Verzeihung for disturbing you. But there's important notice from the Duchess. Something else in relation to Verzeihung is, kannst du mir diese Dummheit verzeihen? Kannst du mir diese Dummheit verzeihen? Can you forgive my foolishness? Kannst du mir diese Dummheit verzeihen? Literally would mean, can you forgive this stupid thing I did, basically. Then there is es tut mir leid, or just tut mir leid. Es tut mir leid is more polite, obviously, because you add the S in the beginning than just tut mir leid. And literally this means it does me sorrow, or it does me suffering. You could also say das tut mir leid. For example, if someone says, oh, I lost my job recently, really sucks, then you can say das tut mir leid. Or if you have done something wrong and want to apologize, you could say es tut mir leid. Es tut mir leid that I have wronged you. And if you're really sorry about it, then you can say es tut mir wirklich leid. Es tut mir wirklich leid. I'm really sorry. Es tut mir wirklich leid, dass ich dir das Geld erst so spät zurückgebe. Es tut mir wirklich leid, dass ich dir das Geld erst so spät zurückgebe. I'm really sorry for giving you back the money so late. There's different ways of saying sorry, but what do you say when you want to express your condolences, when someone had a loss in the family and you want to, well, apologize for it in the right way? Then you say, mein aufrichtiges Beileid in German. Mein aufrichtiges Beileid, my honest condolences. Mein aufrichtiges Beileid. You could just say mein Beileid, but that is of course not as polite as if you would say mein aufrichtiges Beileid. Mein Beileid. I mean, you could say that. It's not super rude, but it's also not super polite. And you want to make sure that you're polite in these kind of situations. And if you want to be extra polite and caring, then you could say mein tiefstes Mitgefühl und aufrichtiges Beileid. Mein tiefstes Mitgefühl und aufrichtiges Beileid. My deepest empathy, basically, Mitgefühl and deepest condolences. Next up, if someone says something to you, for example in German, and you don't understand right away and want him to repeat this, then you could say, wie bitte? Wie bitte? Das habe ich nicht verstanden. I'm sorry, I didn't get this. Wie bitte? Wie bitte? How, please? How, please? I didn't understand. Wie bitte? Das habe ich nicht verstanden. You could also just say, was? Was? Das habe ich nicht verstanden. Was? But that is not polite at all. Was? Hä? 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 Was? I mean, you could say that to your friend, obviously, if you can't be bothered to say, wie bitte? And actually, I wouldn't say, wie bitte? Probably to my friends, I would say, huh, was? Because it doesn't matter as much with friends. These were some of the most standard ways of apologizing, but of course in different situations you would use different kinds of sentences to reply. And here are some examples. For example, if you regret that a relationship failed and you are still on good terms kind of with your ex and you wanna, well, say something like, I'm really sorry for it not having worked out with the two of us. Then you could say in German, es ist wirklich schade, dass es mit uns nicht geklappt hat. Es ist wirklich schade, dass es mit uns nicht geklappt hat. It's a real pity that it didn't work out with the two of us. Or if you want to emphasize that you won't do something again, then you can say, ich werde es nicht noch einmal tun. Ich werde es nicht noch einmal tun. I won't do it again. Or if you're at your job or somewhere where you want to take the full responsibility, then you can say, ich übernehme die volle Verantwortung. Ich übernehme die volle Verantwortung. I take full responsibility. Similarly, if you made a mistake and want to assure the other person that, well, that won't happen again, then you can say, ich werde dafür sorgen, diesen Fehler nicht wieder zu begehen. Ich werde dafür sorgen, diesen Fehler nicht wieder zu begehen. Ich werde dafür sorgen, diesen Fehler nicht wieder zu begehen or nicht wieder zu machen. Ich werde dafür sorgen, diesen Fehler nicht wieder zu machen. Begehen or machen can be used interchangeably here. While begehen sounds a little bit more formal, obviously. Again, if you want to apologize for having done something wrong, then you can say, ich hätte es nicht tun sollen. Ich hätte es nicht tun sollen. I shouldn't have done it. Ich hätte es nicht tun sollen. And if you're worried that someone is mad at you, but you don't want them to be mad at you, you can say, bitte sei nicht böse auf mich. Bitte sei nicht böse auf mich. Please don't be mad at me. Bitte sei nicht böse auf mich. But if you're sure that it's not your fault, then you could say, es ist nicht meine Schuld. Es ist nicht meine Schuld. It's not my fault. Es ist nicht meine Schuld. Or if you didn't mean something, then you can say, das habe ich nicht so gemeint. Das habe ich nicht so gemeint. I didn't mean it that way. Or es war nicht so gemeint. Es war nicht so gemeint. It wasn't meant that way. Another way of saying this is, das war nicht mein Ernst. For example, if you made a really bad joke or maybe some joke that hurt someone's feelings, then you can say, das war nicht mein Ernst. I wasn't serious. Das war nicht mein Ernst. And if you then regret having made that bad joke, you can say, ich bedauere es sehr. Ich bedauere es sehr. I really regret it. And if you regret that someone isn't there, for example at a party, then you can say, es ist schade, dass er nicht hier ist. Es ist schade, dass er nicht hier ist. It's a pity he isn't here. Es ist schade, dass er nicht hier ist. And last but not least, if you took something without asking and you feel sorry about this, then you can say, ich hätte es nicht nehmen sollen, ohne zu fragen. Ich hätte es nicht nehmen sollen, ohne zu fragen. I shouldn't have taken it without asking. Ich hätte es nicht nehmen sollen, ohne zu fragen. So these were different and better ways of saying Entschuldigung, sorry in German. If you have any more, if I forgot some, then let me know in the comments below. I'm really curious to see what you guys know and well, how much has this video helped you. Also let me know this. If you enjoyed this video and if it was helpful, leave a like, subscribe to this channel. And if you want to support me and this channel even more, you can well share it with your friends or even consider becoming a patron on patreon.com/getgermanized or a channel member here on YouTube by clicking the join button next to the subscription button after having subscribed to the channel. There we go, long sentence. And social media, I got that too. Instagram, very cool. I upload pictures and stories on there and I have other social media down here. You can check all of that out. And well, I say apart from that, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to get Germanized. Goodbye and auf Wiedersehen.